All right, hi everyone. Welcome to the Syncfusion webinar focusing on 2019's Volume 2 updates to our mobile libraries. My name is Carter Harris. I am the Video Marketing Specialist here at Syncfusion and will be your moderator today. Our presenter will be Michael Prabhu-M, Product Manager here at Syncfusion. And now, I will go ahead and pass it over to Michael to start this presentation.
Thanks, Carter. Hi guys, this is Michael here, and I'm one of the product managers at Syncfusion. And I see through the development of the database controls like chat, maps, gauges, tree map, and image editor in Xamarin Forms. And here I am today to present what's new in our Xamarin Forms platform for our Volume 2 2019 release. So without further delay, let's dive into the agenda of this session. I have planned this session to point out the exciting new features in our Xamarin platform, along with a demo on creating new application to showcase the new controls like switch and step progress bar. And I'm excited to share that we have released our Xamarin UI toolkit a couple of days back, and I will give you an overview on that as well. So let's move on to the first session. First, I'd like to point out the controls that have moved from preview to its final version in this release, and they are the cards, accordion, and the expander. In this release, we have introduced two new controls, the switch and the step progress bar. The switch control has various features like built-in visual types, which has material, Cupertino, and Fluent styles. It has intermediate state apart from on and off state. It supports a visual state manager to customize the switch thumb based on its visual state. It also supports orientation, gradient colors, and RTL. Next is a step progress bar, which can display progress horizontally and vertically. It has three states like not started, in progress, and completed. You can customize the shape of the state like circle or square. You can also add description on both the sides. And you can customize the step content with tick, dots, images, etc. I will show you a demo on this now. If you are not aware, I like to inform you all that all these demos are available as an application in Play Store. For Android, you can search Syncfusion Control Explorer and you can install it and interact with these demos. I have already installed this in my mobile. So the new controls switch. So as you can see here, we have so many switches here, and we also have a switch with intermediate state. Since everything, there are on and off switches, it is an intermediate state. If all the switches are in on state, then it goes to on state. If all the switches are in off state, then it goes to off state. And if you want to change all the switches to off, then you can click on this. So this is one new such use case that you can cover with a new switch control. And as I said, we have the visual types like material, Cupertino, and Fluent. And also you have the visual state manager. So you have the states like enabled and disabled. Based on the visual states, you can set the color, you can change the button styles, all these things are possible. And also we have a new busy indicator on the switch. This is basically used for asynchronous operation. For example, if you have any asynchronous operation, you can click on the button and you can have a busy indicator loading, and then the switch turns to on state. So this is possible with the with the switch control. You can also have the orientation for horizontal and vertical. You can have gradient colors, and also you can customize the switch with the image, as like we have done here. We have the day and night mode here. So these things are possible with our switch control. The next is a step progress bar. As I said, the step progress bar is basically used to show any progress of, for example, in day-to-day life, if you want to track a package, then this is possible with these animations. And as I said, you can change the content with a tick or any images. And as I said, you can also have the description on both the sites, like here in this, here you can see live train tracking. So Here you can see the content is on both the sides of the progress bar. And you can also have horizontal progress bar as like here. So this is these are the two new controls that we have introduced. The next set of features that I like to talk about is from the accordion, and it has some enhancements this release, like theme support. You can now switch between dark and light theme. You have bindable layer support, which allows the accordion to generate its content by binding it to a collection of items. The accordion has VSM support. Now appearance can be customized based on the visual states of accordion items. Now the button control has gradient color background support. So you can customize the background with gradient colors. Also, accessibility support is given for the controls like button, checkbox, chips, PDF viewer, and radio button. And the calendar control now has week, century, and decades view. I'll show you a demo on all these controls now. So the accordion has the theme support. So I have chosen the accordion here, and I'm going to choose dark theme here. So the accordion supports the dark theme. As I said, the button now has the background color as gradient. Here you can give linear gradient or radial gradient. Both are possible. The calendar control has month, decade, and year view. So here it is. So now we have provided decade, century, and day view. So this is possible now. The week view is the modern view of calendar. You can have any number of weeks displayed in a calendar. This is simply useful in the use cases, like for example, if you have so many agendas to show, then you can simply view only one week. And if you click on any particular date, you can show the agenda in the rest of the space. So this is a space-saving week view. So this is one cool feature that we have introduced in calendar. So as I said, we have accessibility support for all these all the other controls. The next control I like to talk about is the chart control, and I'm really excited on its new support for WPF platform and Xamarin Forms. Earlier, we had support for Android, iOS, and UWP. Now we support WPF in Xamarin Forms. And also has some enhancements like direction zooming, which zooms horizontal or vertical based on the pinch gesture direction. Now chart supports waterfall chart type. You can also customize individual axis elements. Let's see a demo on this. So this is the waterfall chart type. Waterfall chart type is basically used to check on the revenue and profit for any sales or any organization. So we have introduced this chart type. And we also have the zooming for diagonal and vertical, diagonal, vertical, and horizontal. So based on the gesture, pinch gesture, it can zoom vertical, it can zoom horizontal, or it can zoom diagonal. So this is possible with the chart zooming now. The next set of enhancements I like to talk about are from the data form, which is now modernized with improved design of data form editors, integrated with text input layout, which provides floating and assistive labels. You have leading and trailing icons and password toggle icon to show or hide passwords. Also provided support to choose either filled or outlined container for data form editors based on the necessity and appearance of the application. Let's see a demo. So as you can see, here is the leading icons like, you know, the email icon, the phone icon, the birthday cake icon. So these things are now possible with the data form. And as I said, the outline of the outlined content of the data form can be customized. You know, you have the corner radius, and these things are now possible with the data form. The other set of features I like to discuss is from the data grid, which now supports stacked headers that span across multiple columns. So columns in data grid can be grouped under common column headers. You also have combo box column type support, which allows you to easily choose an item from a list of items in the combo box. It also provides autocomplete support to easily search and select an item in a dropdown. Also, you can now disable diagonal scrolling in data grid. Data grid can scroll vertical or horizontal based on how the user is panning. Let's see a demo on this. So this is the combo box editing that I have talked about. So if you want to edit any data, you can choose from the combo box itself. So this is a new feature that we have introduced. So this is a stacked header feature. So the stacked header is, you know, you can span any number of columns so that, you know, you will have a clear representation of the data. Here you can see the order shipment details is categorized into is order details and customer details. And order detail is grouped into order ID and order date. And customer detail is grouped into customer ID and contact name. So all these are now stacked in such a way it is easily understandable. And it is a good feature to show these kind of grouped data. So this feature is now available with DataGrid. The next set of features are from the controls like list view, maps, PDF viewer, and pop-up layout. In list view, we have provided right to left support, and we have added sticky footer position support. So basically the sticky footer, you can set the position so that the footer will always remain in that position whenever you, scroll the list view. In the maps, we have provided support to render polyline and shapes. The polyline is used to render any path over a map, like for example, rivers that flow in a particular area in a map, or to show a direction from driving from one place to another. We have also enhanced the marker alignment in the maps. In PDF viewer, we have provided support for custom stamp annotation, along with some search enhancements to find the content easily in a PDF. Next, in pop-up layout, we have provided support to auto size the layout based on the content. And also now you can set background color to the overlay when a pop-up pop-outs. So let's see a demo on all of this. So this is the polyline support that I have been talking about. So here you can see we have drawn the rivers in Australia using the polyline support. As I said, you can also use it for mapping the direction between two destinations. So these things are possible with maps. And we have also support for marker alignment in maps. That is basically an enhancement. The PDF viewer now has the annotation. This is the custom stamp annotation. We have basically formulated some custom stamps here, like approved, confidential. So, you can edit all these things with the annotation. And as I said, we have done some search enhancements, so you can search easily what are the contents that are available. So this is such feature that we have introduced here. And in pop-up layout, as you can see, that you can see there are so many different sizes of pop-up layout here. This is because it automatically resizes based on the content inside the pop-up. So here you go. I'll show a demo on this. So this is a pop-up with different content. And this is a pop-up with different content and different size. And this is a pop-up with different content and different size. So all these are now possible with the pop-up layout. The next set of features are from the schedule, text input layout, tree map, and tree view. In the schedule, we have provided the much awaited timeline and resource view. We had a lot of requests on this feature, and we have provided the support for this now. The tree map has drill down support with cool animation. The text input layout now supports combo box and autocomplete. You can customize the outline corner radius and change the container background. And in tree view, you can adjust the node height. We have provided the node height support so that you can adjust the node height. Let's see a demo on this. So this is the timeline view. So each day is categorized into every hour. And in this case, you can see from 12 a.m. to 12 p.m. So as I said, this is the timeline view. You can have all your agendas depicted here based on the timeline. So, and it is easy and it is smooth itself. And it has no performance lag. It is good. It has good performance. So this is basically the timeline view. And the resource view is basically, you know, if you want to see all the agendas at one place, and if you have four or five resources together, for example, in this use case, you can see, in this use case, you can see there are five employees, and you can see all their agendas at once. And this is a resource view that we have introduced with the schedule. In the text input layout, as I said, we can now customize the outline corner radius. As you can see, we have given the corner radius here, and you have the autocomplete support here. So you have the autocomplete support here. And you can also see that the container has been set. We have set a background for this container as gray. So this is a feature that we have introduced in text input layout. In tree map, we have the drill down support. So you can drill down into any levels to see that particular data. So here we have two levels. I have given two levels in this sample. And it has cool animation to zoom in and zoom out. So drill down and so drill in and drill out. So that is possible with tree map. I also like to talk about what's new in our file format libraries and in Excel. And in Excel, we have provided drop line Excel charts, which is nothing but a line rendered vertically towards the x-axis to showcase the right value of the data in the axis, and also provided trace precedence and dependence. These are methods used to get the precedence and dependence value. Now the PDF supports the version 2.0, and you can add comments for the annotation. Earlier, you can add comments for the contents, but not for the annotation, but now that is possible. The PowerPoint library has write protection, and the Word library has mail merge enhancements, and you can draw shapes in Word and group them, and you can convert the Word to PDF in RTL. So let's dive into the second part of the session. uh, So to save time, I have created a Xamarin Forms project in Visual Studio. And I like to inform you that we have support for toolbox. As you can see here, we have the Syncfusion Xamarin toolbox available in Visual Studio. And you can download our Xamarin extensions from the Visual Studio Marketplace. As you can see, I have the Syncfusion Extension Studio for Xamarin, and you can also launch the toolbox from here. So as I have already installed all this, I'm just going to add the SF step progress bar and the switch control here to see how easy it is to initialize these controls. I've just drag and dropped here inside the stack layout. And as you could see here, all the nuggets that are required is already been added here. So the extension does the heavy work for you. So you need not worry about configuring all these things from the scratch. So now the extension take care of all these things. I'm just going to run this and show you how these controls are initialized here. So if you want to learn about these new controls, you can go to our help.syncfusion.com and choose Xamarin Forms, and all the required APIs and how to get started are all available here. So I'm going to open a subswitch, and as you can see here, we have the getting started for the switch here. And as I said, we have all the APIs and all these things are documented clearly, so that you can jumpstart your application at the earliest way possible. So the app is ready now. So as you can see here, this is the default appearance of the switch and the step progress bar. So if you want to change the orientation, that is possible. And if you want to change, if you want to enable the intermediate state, then that is possible. Let me show that. So the APIs allow intermediate state to true. So the orientation, I'm going to set it as vertical now. So as I said, all these things are available in the documentation. So I recommend you guys to go and check this out. So there you go. So now you have the intermediate state, and you have the on state and off state. And I have also changed the orientation to vertical. So it is very easy. So what I really wanted to show here is the extension does the heavy work, and we have introduced the toolbox here. So all these things does the heavy work for you, and you need not worry about configuring the Syncfusion controls anymore. So everything is already pre-configured, and all you have to do is drag and drop, and all the APIs and all these things are clearly documented, and you can go and visit our website, and you can take advantage of that. And I'm really excited to introduce our new essential UI kit for Xamarin. We have launched this a couple of days back, and the key features that we have introduced for the Xamarin UI kit last time we have introduced this with the Essential Studio itself. Now we are having this as a separate product. And last time we had login pages, sign up pages, forget password pages, and we had four screens. Now we have 35 plus screens. And also we have rich and elegant XAML layouts for most common scenarios, so that you know you can easily create any application, and you have all the things that are all the prerequisites for an application is already ready here as a template. You can just drag and you can just add our pages, and you know you are good to go. All these layouts are also optimized for phones, tablets, and desktop. And it is you know designed using the MVM design pattern, so you can work with the MVM framework, and it is easily integratable. So since it is available as a extension in Visual Studio Market, you can easily integrate it. We have the developer friendly APIs, and the appearance is customized. The appearance is customizable using styles. And you have very best possible performance, so there will not be any lag in this. And we also support from right to left rendering. So we are really excited about our essential UI kit. We have all this entire package available in all these source available in GitHub. You can go to GitHub and browse through our Syncfusion repository for essential UI kit for XAML and forms. And as I said before, we also have the extension available in the marketplace in Visual Studio. So you can go there and install our extension, and you're good to go. And if you want to see what are the possibilities of these UI kit and what kind of application that we can create, we have already created a demo app for this. You can go to the Play Store and you can search for Syncfusion XAML UI kit, and you can download it. And since we have launched it, it is in early stages. We have a blog ready for you, so that you can visit this blog and you can see how you can get started with these things. And one more thing is, we have planned to have a webinar on coming August 15th to showcase how easy it is to create an application in just under 20 minutes using our essential UI kit. So I'll be taking that session as well. So if you guys like this, if you guys like our essential UI kit, please join there, and you will have plenty of information on how to get started with these things and how to create an application within just 20 minutes. So that's all from my side for now. Hope you like the new features we have introduced, and thanks for joining this webinar. And let me pass on to Carter now. Hi, Carter. You can take it from here.
All right, thank you, Michael. All right, everyone. Well, before we begin our Q&A session, I'd like to briefly tell you a little bit about Syncfusion. So Syncfusion delivers an extensive range of over 1,000 web, mobile, and desktop controls. We also empower businesses to get the most out of their data with our enterprise solutions, including the dashboard and big data platforms. We have been in business for over 17 years and are headquartered in the Raleigh-Durham area of North Carolina in the U.S. Syncfusion has more than 12,000 customers, including large financial institutions, Fortune 100 companies, and global IT consultancies. More than 1 million users from 125 countries trust Syncfusion in the development process. To keep up to date with us and gain access to tons of instructional videos and other great content, you can follow us on social media. We have Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and YouTube accounts, and these provide a great platform for us to communicate and update our users and hear their feedback. Speaking of feedback, we have a G2 crowd page, which is a peer-to-peer review site. So if you'd like to check out what other users have to say about Syncfusion, or like to share your own feedback, we'd love to hear from you. So I just want to thank you all for joining us today, and I want to thank Michael again for presenting.
Thank you, Carter.
And we will see you all next time. I hope you all have a great rest of your day.